My name is Yesha Naik, and I'm a Youth Services Librarian at Brooklyn Public Library. My family, we are first-generation immigrants. I came to this country with my parents when I was a little over 1 year old, and my mother was thrilled when she discovered that you could borrow books from the library for free. And so every week, we walked the 1 mile to the public library. We borrowed the maximum number of books. I remember from the age of 3 that she would sit in her bedroom and read books to me one after the other in her painstaking English. And you know, to me, Dr. Seuss always will have an Indian accent. and that's how I fell in love with stories. And I just thought there was no more magical place than a library. My first few months working at Brooklyn Public Library, I was a trainee, and this older gentleman came in. He was a Chinese immigrant. He was obviously not very well, and he came in with his application for citizenship. He had missed his interview date, and that, you know, this was not a good thing, and he needed to write a letter back to explain what happened. And it turned out that he was in the hospital during this time. And he didn't have anybody in his immediate family who was able to or willing to write a letter for him. So I helped him to write a letter. Fast forward like 2-3 years, I was working at another branch, which also had, you know, a heavy immigrant population. And a gentleman comes in, you know, smiling, happy, pretty healthy looking, you know, an older gentleman. And he walks right up to me with this big smile on his face, and as if he recognizes me. And I was like, hi, can I help you? And he said, you know, you helped me 2 years ago. You wrote that letter for me, and it really helped. And I got another appointment, and I got to do my application, my interview for my citizenship. And it was such a great feeling that, like, somehow, like, I had a little piece in helping him with his, you know, struggle for immigration. There are just so many immigrants in Brooklyn, and it's been wonderful to be able to give that back, to pay it forward to the next generation. One day I was sitting at the reference desk here in the youth wing, and this gentleman came up to me, and he looked very tentative, and he said, okay, I have a really weird question, and you probably can't help me with it. Many years ago, I read a book, and I'm trying to find that book, but I don't remember the title, and I don't remember the author. I think the book was set sometime after the riots of the 60s, and it was about the friendship between a white girl and a black girl who had just recently moved into the house next door, and there was some uneasiness, and it was about racial relations and friendships also. And as luck would have it, I had just been browsing in the children's fiction section the day before and had picked up a book that I hadn't picked up in like 30 years. So I just looked at him and I said, let me show you something. And I typed in Iggy's house into our catalog, and I showed him the book and the description. I said, could this be the book that you're looking for? And his jaw just dropped to the floor, and he was like, how did you do that? And I was like, well, you know, I'm a librarian.